Lizzie and Caden, we're living in a time of unrest after the surge of recent shootings across our country. Now, it happened at a Walmart similar to this one as the people of El Paso were getting groceries. Now, one couple who was visiting at the time says they never would have thought that a quick trip would have turned catastrophic.
Sounds like firecrackers.
The Ingles stopped for water on their way out of town, not foreseeing the devastation they would soon endure.
People come running through the vegetable aisles going, shooter. White guy with an AK-47. Get out of here.
22 lives lost, including a veteran, a high school student, and a mother who shielded her son.
Blood all over the blanket. Of course, I thought the baby was dead, and I was really just screaming out, that's a baby, that's a baby.
Health professional Josette Klein says initial feelings of fear and being overwhelmed are expected.
It's a normal reaction to an abnormal and scary and frightening and traumatic situation.
Victims may also suffer from symptoms such as re-experiencing of the trauma or avoidance.
We think about arousal symptoms too. People feel sort of keyed up. They're feeling irritable. They're maybe not engaging with friends.
Klein says those symptoms resolve within a month for the vast majority of people, but not all escape from those sleepless nights.
A month or so beyond the trauma, and we're still experiencing symptoms to the level that they had experienced them right after the trauma, that's the time when I would say maybe seek out some support.
But Beverly says there was a power that only evil could bring out.
What I was seeing in the midst of fear was also just this presence of love. Yeah, love.
The Ingles will return to Texas on Thursday to retrieve their car and other belongings. I asked the couple if they felt uneasy at the thought of returning to the crime scene, but David says it's time to face the fact. His top priority, the people of El Paso. Lizzie,